Welcome everybody to another week, to another boss battle. This time it's Arconis. Arconis is one of my favorite bosses, if not my favorite boss. Because we start with 9 mana. So no need for any curve. No need for any 2-drops. No need for anything. You just play big, bad minions. It's so much fun. Though Arconis has one ability. At the end of each turn, deal damage to the player equal to the remaining mana. That means we should use our mana. Also, Arconis has really good stats. 660. Oh, that's nice. But, of course, I built a budget deck for this one. And to be honest, it's one of the easiest bosses. So, practically, play 3 Worldcore Golems and you're fine. But I show you my deck and talk about it, and then we jump into a game. So, this is the budget deck. I chose Varf, so maybe Starhorn would be better because we could use some card draw. So, to be honest, it doesn't matter much. Why did I choose Magma? Actually, there's not much reason. I mean, if you look at my cards, the only Magma cards I play is Cascading Rebirth and Natural Selection. Natural Selection is good here because all minions are kind of strong because everybody has 9 mana, so this is a good removal. I mean, it's always a good removal. And then we can play still a 7-drop and we don't lose any hit points. So that's really, really nice. And is it enough to play Magma? I don't know. You could play. You can play whatever you want. Maybe Vitruvian with Entropic Decay for removal. Whatever. So I try to be very cheap here. Play only commons or basics. And let's see which cards I chose and why. So I started with Worker Golem because this minion alone will win you the game. 3 hits with Worker Golem and they are dead. Then I checked what else is good and cheap. Drybone Golem is a basic. Storm Metal Golem doesn't cost anything. Brightmask Golem. Primal Shieldmaster for Provoke. That day, yeah, why not? I mean, it dies to the boss, but Provoke is still good. And it's a basic card. Repulsor Beast if we need kind of removal. Yeah. And Natural Selection as a great removal tool here. So these are the basic cards in the deck. Let's go about the commons. First of all, I'm gonna say, okay, Worker Golem is a common too. You can replace all of them, you know. You can play whatever you want, which is, and whatever you have, you know. I'm sure you have some random legendary, like Red Cincha. Yeah, play it, it's really good. Or whatever you have, it doesn't matter much. It's only important it should have more than 6 hit points, because then it survives one attack of the general, the boss. I mean, I chose War Talon because he has Frenzy in Provoke, and bosses never play around Frenzy, so nice. Ember Worm has amazing stats. First Sword of a Crane. Good stats and buffs our other minions. Deathblighter, not so great stats, but I thought maybe need the damage. Not sure, this didn't perform that well, to be honest. But whatever. Dancing Blades, not the best stats against this boss because it's 6 hit points, but it's still a solid minion. So, yeah, but there's so many choices what you can do. Cascading Rebirth I added because it would be fun. I imagine like having Storm Metal Golem attack all day and then it has only 2 hit points left, and we use Cascading Rebirth and get, what do we get? Either Silver Elder, which would be amazing, or Unstable Leviathan, which could be fun too. Or even if we have Ember Worm, I think there's we always get out of Ember Worm, we get a Juggernaut. So I thought, yeah, I wanna play this. Spoilers? I didn't draw the card. So, like I said, just play big boys. I didn't see a lot of removal anyway, so
yeah,
feel free to play what you want. So I really like starting with Dryborn Golem and Natural Selection, so I replace both 5 drops because I thought maybe I need that. Then I replace one of the 6 drops and got a Worker Golem, best start ever. Just put it here and move kind of back a little bit. Be careful, you want the BBS of the boss. It deals 2 damage to the enemy general and stuns all nearby enemy minions. So you won't have... don't be too close to your minions. Here it's now Natural Selection does a lot of work. Removes his 3 drop. And we play a nice 7 drop. And don't lose any damage. I move on further back, but it's more... You don't have to do that. I just did it because I didn't want to be in range of them hitting me. Even though there was a provoke here and a body blocking minion. But I could have stayed too. Maybe even better to clean something up or whatever. Now I'm kind of angry that I replaced my Crane because now I can't kill the Bastion. Crane would be really good here. I decided to play Dryborn Golem just because it's super strong. Then I considered, should I use my Natural Selection on the Bastion? I decided not to do that. But maybe I should have. It didn't matter really. I mean, now the War Talon dies and I can't reach a Bastion anymore, but not that important, I mean, because they're dead. They didn't run and they don't have removal for the Vodka Golem, so it doesn't matter. Yeah. And that's the game. A very short video. Volker Golem just destroys this boss. Yeah, this was this week's boss. One of my favorite. I played it more than once. I played with some fun decks like a Nematon deck or even a Grandmaster Varix Maeve deck. Because you have 9 mana, you can do a lot of shenanigans. And just enjoy it. Because, yeah, I think everybody has these monstrous late game decks or ideas, but you never have the mana because usually you die before that. So against this boss, live your fantasies. Do whatever you want. And it's you will win. So, thanks for watching. If you have any questions, post them down in the comments. I would also appreciate if you leave me a comment how you liked my content. And like the video, follow my channel. And I see you everybody next week. Goodbye.